Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and assalamu alaikum. My name is Muhammad Kamabi Muhammad Noor. My matrix number is TF190101. Today I will make some introduction about the Sieve analysis test. Determination of particle size is more important in civil engineering as the particle size determines the effectiveness of the final product. The character of particles such as bulk density, physical stability, permeability and many more are decided by its size. To determine the size distribution of the particle, the sieve analysis test procedure is an effective method that prevailed from the past. In sieve analysis, the particle size is defined using the mass or volume. The sieve analysis test is laboratory test procedure in which particle will move vertically or horizontally through sieve mesh. Depending on the needs and the particle material, different sieving methods are available for the application. There are manual sieving method, mechanical sieving method, dry sieving method and the wet sieving method.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Amirul Mu'minin bin Muhammad Azim. Okay, I will present about sieve analysis, apparatus and materials. Okay, first, the apparatus are series of standard sieves with opening ranging from 7.5 cm to 75 micrometer, including a cover plate and bottom pan. Okay, second, test sieve having the following aperture size: 10 mm, 6 mm, 1 mm, 0.6 mm, 0.3 mm, 0.15 mm, and then 0.063 mm. Okay, the third is mechanical sieve shaker. And then the fourth, balance sensitive 0.5 gram. And the last one is soft wire brush. And then we use the materials. The materials is fine aggregates. So that's all from me for this presentation about apparatus and material of sieve analysis.
Assalamualaikum and hi, my name is Aiman Nazbin bin Jamil and today I will present about the sieve analysis procedure and I will share some precautions and tips that will help us to avoid mistakes while doing the procedure. Without further ado, I will jump to the presentation. The procedure for sieve analysis is quite simple. Firstly, we need to prepare an oven dry sample. Then, we need to check the sample for any lump or conglomerated particles and crush the lump or not the particles by using the pestle and mortar. Third, we need to determine the mass of the sample accurately to 500 g in weight. Fourth, we need to stack the sieve in order with the largest opening at the top and the smallest opening at the bottom. A pan or receiver is placed on all the sieve to collect the samples. Fifth, we need to weight all the sieve and pan individually. Sixth, we need to carefully pour the samples from the top of the stack of the sieve and place the lid over it. Seventh, we need to place the sieve stack in the manical shaker. Fix the clamp, adjust the timer between 10 to 15 minutes and switch on the device. 8. After the timer stops, we need to remove the stack from the shaker carefully and measure the mass of each sieve with its retained soil. Then we need to record the data in our report. 9. As an addition, remember to weight and record the weight of the bottom of the pan with its retained fine soil. And lastly, it's time to analyze the data. Even though the procedure that I just explained is quite detailed, but if we are not careful, we can also do some mistakes. So here are some reminder of precaution when doing sieve analysis. Firstly, we need to make sure the sieve are clean and dry before starting the procedure. If the sieve are not clean and dry, it will interfere with the accuracy of the data that we collected. Secondly, we need to make sure the sieve are stacked in order, where the largest opening will be at the top and the smallest sieve opening will be at the bottom. Third, we do not mistake the sieve number with sieve opening size. If you are sticking with the sieve number, make sure it is in an ascending order. For example, we place the number sieve at the top and we will start ascending to the bottom where the number 200 sieve will be there. And remember to place the pan below the number 200 sieve. And lastly, number 4, if you are using coarse aggregates, select the aggregate that will not damage the sieve when it is being shaken.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Fahim Ramli and I will continue the presentation. My part is data and calculation. After we got all the data from the sieve analysis, we must put all the data into the table as shown in the slides, where M1 is a mass of empty sieve, M2 is a mass of empty sieve plus the mass of soil retain, and M3 is a mass of soil retain. Next, we must calculate the percent retain. We can calculate percent retain by dividing the mass of soil retain by total mass of soil times 100%. Next column, we must calculate the cumulative percent retain. We can calculate cumulative percent retain by adding the percent retain all the way. At the bottom, we will get 100%. Lastly, we must calculate the percent final. For the first point, we must subtract the cumulative percent retain with 100%. Then we continue the calculation by subtracting the cumulative percent retain. At the bottom, we will get 0%. Next, we can calculate coefficient of uniformity, coefficient of curvature, and permeability coefficient using the formula as shown in the slide. Soil that have coefficient uniformity less than 4, it is described as uniform size, while soil that have coefficient of uniformity more than 4, it is described as well-graded soil and it is indicated by a flat curve. Lastly, coefficient of curvature is also known as coefficient of gradation and also coefficient of concavity. Soil that have coefficient of curvature between 1 and 3, it is described as well-graded soil, while soil that have coefficient of curvature outside the range between 1 and 3, it is described as poorly graded soil. After we calculate all the data from the table, we can plot a particle size distribution chart, where the x-axis is the particle size and the y-axis is the percent final. After plotting the graph, we can show the D10, D30 and D60 from the graph. That's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Faris bin Muhammad Fauzi. Today I want to present about the example problem of sieve analysis. Okay, from the questions, we can see the sieve analysis was performed on a soil in the laboratory. The sieve retained on each sieve are given below. So we can see the table which is have the sieve size and the mass of soil retained. So the question is about the plot a grain size distribution curve for the soil. Calculate the coefficient of uniformity, which is Cu, and the coefficient of curvature, which is Cc. And classify the soil according to the Unified Soil Classification System, USCS. So this is the solution about the question above. First step, you must to find out the value of percent final and cumulative retain. Cumulative retain value will get from the additional part, which is the first value of cumulative retain will plus with the second value of mass of soil, and we can get the second value of cumulative retain, and so on. By the way, the percent final by mass we can get from the subtraction, which is the first value of percent final will minus the second value of cumulative retain, and we can get the second value of percent final. So from the table, we can plot the graph, which is percent final versus particle size. Next, we must determine the value of D10, D30 and D60 from the graph. If we have this value, we can calculate the value of coefficient, which is coefficient of curvature and coefficient of uniformity. The equation of coefficient of curvature is D30 square divided by D10 multiplied by D60, and we can get the value of Cc. For coefficient of uniformity, the equation is D60 divided by D10, so we can get the value of Cu. So the last step is classify the soil. If we have the value of Cu and Cc, if Cu is equal to 1, grains are all the same size, which is a poorly graded. If Cu is more than 1, grains are well graded. If Cc is more than 1 and less than 3, which is a smooth curve, Cc in a well graded state. If a Cc less than 1 or Cc more than 3, which is curve not smooth, poorly graded. So the value of Cu we get from the equations, we get 3.4. It's greater than 1, so it is a well graded. So the value of Cc is 1.17, is greater than 1 and less than 3, so it is a well graded too.
We go back to the conclusion. I conclude that to know if end aggregates are good to be used in construction of structure and buildings is that we have to save an amount of gravel and sand from cores down into fine pieces wherein different sides will be separated, and we'll see if the sieve aggregates are well balanced, our graph will present. Each sieve size will show which have more and less amount. Aggregates that are used to be used in construction must consist the different size, which is fine and coarse, because it will help our structure to be stronger and thick. I conclude that we have success and reached the objective of this project for this experiment and learn how to use the separate and different size of aggregates through sieving and graph them to see if the percentage of each size are connected and good to be used in construction different structure. We may apply it in the field of engineering, most especially in construction of structures like buildings, roads and buildings. Okay, for the recommendation for this experiment, I will make some advice to everybody who want to running the experiment. When doing this experiment, it is suggested to clean first the sieve that we are going to use with a brush to remove excess and unnecessary things inside that may affect our result. Because sample will get stuck if we don't clean it, then we'll lessen our accuracy. Do the task accurately but make sure to be in order to not put more aggregates because it may get hard for it to sink and get into the pan, and also it is heavy that it might fall. Sieve the aggregates carefully so the way we get a better accepted sieve analysis result, and the graph will show how accurate we are, as well as the graph will show you how the good sample aggregates we have used that is better used in the different construction. Okay, I think that's all about me. Thank you for watching. Assalamualaikum.